This is Martin Sixsmith, used to be the BBC's man in Moscow.
And Washington.
You're depressed.
Well, I got the sack. I'm unemployed.
Yes, but it wasn't your fault, was it?
That's why I'm depressed.
What are you working on at the moment?
I know this woman. She had a baby when she was a teenager. She's kept it secret for 50 years.
You're talking about a human interest story, and that's... I don't do those.
Why not?
You think I should do a human interest story? Philomena, how are you?
I had a hip replacement last year, Martin. Titanium, so it won't rust.
Otherwise, I'd have to oil you like the Tin Man.
Is that right?
Oh, no.
He's just joking, Mum.
Oh. I was going to ask if it would be possible not to use my real name when you write the story. What about Anne Boleyn? That's a lovely name. Oh, somebody had that.
We're going to have to use your real name, Philomena.
I only want to know if he's all right.
Perhaps these older nuns should help us with some of the details.
I don't think that's going to be possible.
Why not?
You're a journalist.
I used to be.
Martin's a Roman Catholic.
Yes, well, no, I used to be. My guess is that Anthony was adopted and sent to America.
I think I would like to go. I'd like to know if Anthony ever thought of me. I've thought of him every day.
Should we go for a walk?
Or we could watch Big Mama's House. It's about a little black man pretending to be a fat black lady. It looked hilarious, Martin.
She told four people today that they were one in a million. What are the chances of that?
Oh! What if he died in Vietnam? Or lived on the street? Or what if he was obese?
What on earth makes you think he'd be obese?
Because of the size of the portions.
That's my Anthony.
I met him.
Where?
At the White House.
Dear God, what was he like? And did you remember anything he said?
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
He might have been high.
Oh, Martin.
I did not abandon my child.
He was taken from me.
She's been looking for him. She spent her whole life trying to find him.
I've never been to Mexico, but I believe it's lovely. Apart from the kidnappings.
My husband is, well, he's required to speak publicly.
I have received
Perhaps he should change jobs.
And what of my husband with a king? My husband has seen everyone.
Insert them into your mouth. Enunciate.
He hasn't seen me. I can cure your husband, but I need total trust. What was your earliest memory?
I'm not here to discuss personal matters.
Well, why are you here, then?
Because I bloody well stammer!
But do you know any jokes?
Timing isn't my strong suit.
Your methods were unorthodox and controversial.
Up comes your royal highness.
It's actually quite good fun.
Yes. Art thou afeared?
It's your peculiar.
I take that as a compliment.
War with Germany will come, and we will need a king whom we can all stand behind.
He's afraid of his own shadow.
The nation believes that when I speak for them, but I can't speak.
You could do it. You needn't be governed by fear.
It'll be like Mad King George the Stammer. Get up! You can't sit there! Get up!
Why not? It's a chair.
That is St. Edward's chair.
People have carved their names.
Listen to me! Listen to me!
Why should I waste my time listening to
you? Because I have a voice!
Yes, you do.
Your greatest test is yet to come.
Bring it out of my...
What's he saying?
I don't know, but he seems to be saying it rather well. Your first wartime speech.
Broadcast to the nation and the world.
This great time of crisis.
However this turns out, I don't know how to thank you. Bertie, you're the bravest man I know.
I intend to be a very good queen.
To a very great king.
Forget everything else and just say it to me.